Hi, I'm Sari from Sharetribe. In this video, we will change the font in your Sharetribe marketplace. We will get our font script from Google Fonts, include the font script in the codebase, use the font in our marketplace, check our results locally, create a commit and push our changes to the remote repository, and review our results in our deployed website. To follow this tutorial, you will need to be working with a custom-hosted version of Sharetribe, as we will be directly customizing the code. We are now looking at the deployed version of our test template. Let's open the local version so we can see our changes. So let's open Visual Studio Code and open our web template in VS Code. To run our template locally, we can do yarn run dev, which runs the template and opens it in a local host port. As we can see, this is now using the default font. Let's change that. Let's go to Google Fonts. In this video, we will use a font called Barlow. It has a few different styles. We will select regular 400. And here we can see a few different options to embed the font. We will use the import version. So select import and then copy the whole thing by clicking this button onto your clipboard. In the template then, we will go to source, util, and include scripts. And here we have several different scripts already being included by default, the map libraries and analytics libraries mostly. So here we will add a new snippet and we will call it constant font script. And then we'll paste the script that we copied. Now to use this, we will still need to wrap the part within the style tags. We'll need to wrap it with curly braces and backticks. You can copy this whole snippet from the video description. Finally, in this file, we'll still need to include this. So this all scripts array is where we want to add our font script. So add a comma next to the final one and then just include the font script. Remember to save. To add the font or to use the font, we will need to go to source, styles, and marketplace defaults. And we can search for font family. This is where the different fonts that we use in the template get added. So we want to primarily use the Barlow font. So let's add it as the first one and save our changes. Now we can see, even without refreshing, that your template is now using the new font. If we want to include these changes into the deployed version, we will again have to make a commit. So we can see our changes. We've now made changes to two files, marketplace defaults and include scripts. We are happy with both of these changes, so we can stage them to be included in the commit, and then we'll add a message. Change font and commit. Now again, if we hover over sync changes, it would want to push it to upstream/main. And let's take a look at what our remotes say. Git remote B. So we can check what's upstream and what's origin. These are the different repositories connected to our template. Origin is my own one. This is where I want to push the changes. Upstream, which is behind this button, is actually the Sharetribe general web template repository, I don't want to push my changes there, which means it's better to make the push from the command line. And we are in the main branch here, so we can do git push origin. This is the repository we want to push our changes, and main. We have now pushed our changes, and render will take a while to deploy them. Now we can click refresh on our deployed version, and we can see that the font change has deployed. And that's it. You have now changed the font on your Sharetribe Marketplace web template. In this video, we copied the font script from Google. We added the script into the include scripts file, and we used the font in the Marketplace defaults file.